Have you ever wanted to mod your Nintendo Switch, but never knew where to start? Well, you've come to the right place. I've had my Switch modded for about 2.5 years now, and I can mod a Switch in under 20 minutes. But because I will explain everything to you in detail, it will be a little bit longer than that. Modding a Nintendo Switch does have its risks. So, what are they? And how can I prevent them? The first risk is getting banned from online. A lot of people are afraid of this happening, but it can be prevented. If you decide to use online play after modding your Nintendo Switch, just power off your Switch completely and boot it into the official firmware. But what if you want to keep your mods active while going online? Easy. Make sure the mods you want to use online cannot affect others. Make sure it's mods that only affect your Switch. For example, do use skin mods online. Those are safe since only you can see them. Do not use game-changing files that others can see. An example would be on Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, there are mods for adding Giga Bowser as a playable fighter, or separating Popo and Nana and the Pokemon trainers, or adding extra stages into those games. Using those online for others to see can get you banned. The second risk is breaking your Switch. This is a big, scary risk a lot of people are afraid of. So, what can you do to prevent it? Check your serial number. Switches that were bought in a red box are considered version 2 switches, or the Mariko version. Those cannot be modded without soldering in a mod chip, which are very expensive. Switch lights cannot be modded without a mod chip. Same with the OLED. Only version 1 switches that came in a white box can be modded. If you forgot what version switch you have, or are unsure if you have a version 1 or version 2 switch, you can look up your serial number. That number can be located in two different places. On the bottom of your Switch, there is a white sticker with a bunch of numbers. That is your serial number. If that's too small to read, you can go into your system settings and scroll down to system, then scroll to serial information and look at the console row. Once you have your serial number, head over to ismyswitchpatch.com and check it there. To check, go to that website, put in your extension, and then put in the following 6 numbers. Yours may be different to mine. 3. Crashes. Everyone hates crashes. So, here's how to try and prevent it. Whenever you launch an app on custom firmware, or CFW to make it short, make sure to hold. If you want to load a custom app like RetroArch, or emulators, or other types of apps, hold R while launching an app to use a title override and open the app in full RAM mode rather than applet mode. So what do you need to mod your Switch? 1. You will need a PC. You will also need a RCM jig. You can get one for as low as $7 USD on Amazon. You will also need a USB to USB-C cable. Make sure it can be used to transfer data. A version 1 switch, a micro SD card reader, a micro SD card around 64 gigabytes or larger. I'm using a SanDisk Ultra 512 gigabyte micro SD. Now, what do you need on your computer? First, you have to download Tegra RCM from the respective GitHub description below. Open up the launcher and set it up. Once Tegra RCM is set up, make sure it is open and head over to the Drivers tab and click Install Drivers. If you get an error, just click OK and continue to install the drivers. Now, how do I set up my Switch? First, you want to power off your Switch completely. So to do that, you're going to hold down the power button for 12 seconds and click More Options and Power Off. It may take less time, Then, take out your SD card and back up your Nintendo folder and all your screenshots and videos. Put that on your desktop for easy access. Next, you have to format your SD card to FAT32. Doing that will erase everything from the SD card, so make sure you definitely back up that Nintendo folder. So there are two ways of doing that. The first option is to use a PC program called FAT32GUI. To do this option, download the program linked in the description and find your SD card on the program. Make sure the format is selected to FAT32. When you do this, all of your data will be erased. The second option is by using Tegra RCM to inject a Tegra Explorer payload. To do this, click the link to get to the Tegra Explorer GitHub page. Download TegraExplorer.bin. Remember, all links will be down in the description below. Then on Tegra RCM, click the icon that shows a folder with a magnifying glass. Then select your TegraExplorer.bin. Put your SD card into your Switch. Put your RCM jig into the right Joy-Con slot. When you plug in your Switch to your PC, press the volume up and power button at the same time to enter RCM mode. Then, on Tegra RCM, click Inject Payload. On your Switch, you can now unplug your RCM jig and put in the Joy-Cons. Now, scroll down to SD Format. Click on FAT32 only, and click Yes on the warning. This will erase everything. Once that's done, scroll back down and click power off. Then, put your SD card back into your Switch. Now, before we continue, I will link a repack in the description below. It is a bare bones, the absolute bare minimum of what you need to launch into Atmosphere. Everything in that pack I talk about in this tutorial. That's the easiest way. Every time Atmosphere updates, the repack will update. When you use this option, drag and drop everything except for the README into the root of your SD card. The README will tell you what's in the repack and how to update if needed. It will also tell you what version of Atmosphere and Switch firmware the repack is designed for. Now, the repack is just a bunch of files, but you still have yet to learn how to get into custom firmware. That will also be in the README. But if you're still confused, skip to the timestamp in the description called Launching Custom Firmware. If you're a hands-on learner and want to know where to put each file, keep watching this tutorial. Now, here's what to download. All links in the description below. You'll need to download Atmosphere. Fusee.bin. It's in the same link that you get Atmosphere from. You also need to download Hecate. Hecateipl.ini. Bootlogos.zip. Lockpickrcm.bin. jksv.nro. ftpdpro.nro. hbappstore.nro and nxshell.nro. Now, where on earth do these files go? Don't worry, I know it seems like a lot, but trust me, this is going to be easy and painless. make sure your micro SD card is properly formatted to FAT32 and the SD card is in your computer. Copy the contents of the atmosphere.zip file to the root of your SD card. Then copy the bootloader folder from the hecate.zip file to the root of your SD card. Copy the bootloader folder from the bootlogos.zip file to the root of your SD card. If you're asked to merge the bootloader folders, do so. Copy the hecate_ipl.ini to the bootloader folder on your SD card. Copy lockpick_rcm.bin to the bootloader payloads folder on your SD card. Create a folder named App Store inside the switch folder on your SD card and put appstore.nro in it. Copy JKSV, FTPD Pro, NX Shell, and NX Themes Installer .nro to the switch folder on your SD card. If you are already using your microSD as a storage device for your games and backed up the Nintendo folder before partitioning your microSD card, please place it back on the root of your SD card. Then reinsert your SD card back into your Switch. Now, how do you launch into custom firmware? Once you're all finished with putting the files in place, whether you did it via my bare bones repack or manually, it's time to launch into custom firmware. Make sure Tegra RCM is open on your computer and you install the drivers. Then on Tegra RCM, click the folder with the magnifying glass on your hecate.bin file and select it. For me, I'm going to be finding my hecate 5.9.0.bin, but yours may be different depending on when you watch this. Put your RCM jig into the right Joy-Con slot. Plug in the Nintendo Switch into your computer. Hit volume, up, and power button almost immediately. Once Tegra RCM says RCM OK, click Inject Payload. Then set your time. Next, hit the Payloads button, and then Lockpick RCM. Click the power button to select Dump from SysNand. Once it's done, you can click any button. Use the volume down to scroll to payloads and scroll to fuse.bin using your volume buttons. Then, click the power button to launch fuse.bin. Congratulations, you are now in modded firmware. What? What can you do? Well, you can wireless file transfer. So to do this, you can click on your albums icon, find FTPD Pro, and click X to star it. That will put it to the front of your page. Then open it by clicking A. On your computer, download and set up FileZilla for any trusted FTP program. Put in your IP address shown on switch screen and put in the port 5000. Now you can transfer files from your PC to the Nintendo Switch or from Nintendo Switch to PC without needing to take out your SD card. You can also mod your games, will be done in a separate video. You can also run emulators, also will be done in a separate video. Installing custom themes will also be done in a future video. And save editing, again, will be done in another video. and there's so much more you can do. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, please smash that like button. Don't forget to subscribe to see more tutorials on modded switches or other random stuff. I hope to see you guys next time. Please share this video with your friends as well. Peace out, everyone.